start by thanking you guys for, first of all, thinking that Abia can be part of history making along the trajectory of growth of our movie industry. We are aware that the contribution of the movie industry to the GDP of Nigeria today is huge, second to oil. And apart from that, it has contributed to the well-being and social upbringing of Nigerians. A lot of young people are employed and have become more popular for what we do in the Nollywood industry than anything else. Nigeria has come under very serious flux in terms of negative publicity aside the shores of our land, but we have received a very comforting buffer from Nollywood. As a country, we think this is the time for us to emphasize and strengthen those things which God has given to us naturally. If we are talking about comparative advantage in Africa and even in the world over, I think our government and the state, federal, even local government should begin to pay more emphasis on the movie industry than done before. Beyond this, there are a few things which we have packaged for the Nollywood industry going forward. We are thinking about the movie village. Initially, I didn't want to get into the politics of what it takes to establish a movie village. But I'm praying and hoping that one day God will bring people like you that can really sit down and talk about it with our government. Devoid of politics and sentiments that are parochial and too narrow from the big picture that all of us want to see. In Abia, there are so many things you can do. Apart from the talent, which is replaced, Abia State, especially Abia, holds very strong promise in terms of market of intellectual property. And as I speak today, beyond the economic recession, Abia contributes more than 50% of whatever marketing after Idomota and Abisha. The next hotbed is Abia in terms of marketing of intellectual property. And one other thing that Nigeria needs to see and acknowledge is that since the past 20 years, Abia and Abia in particular is exporting all kinds of materials, leather, garments, to other parts of Africa. We have conquered the entire West Africa, and we are launching into Africa. But we have met with very stiff opposition and competition with Ethiopia in terms of leather works, because they have industrialized and mechanized their shoe processing enterprise. And that is why we are battling with that aspect of our production chain. You know, but today, I say it without any fear of contradiction that Abia remains the SME capital of Nigeria and the hope of Nigeria tomorrow. If our economy must reside and launch on the pillar of SMEs, is Abia. Beyond this, I am sure also that Abia will be the first city in Nigeria to enjoy not only uninterrupted, but uninterruptible power, courtesy of the matrix. The power is embedded, it's been generated, and the agreement between geometrics and the distribution company of the Gulf was designed, courtesy of Mr. Vice President, and we are sure that in a few months we have uninterrupted power. This will spell out a promise to those who want to come to Abia to do business. Generally speaking also, I want to say that our government understands the importance of what you are doing. And we will do everything to make sure that we support you. On this call, the board I want to see you are determined to join forces with you to make it the best. and set targets that people will find difficult to meet. There are a few things about our place. We say here that if you bend down, you see our back. Bend down. And I will show you how to bend down. At this is my way of saying that you are most welcome to our environment, most welcome to our space, and we will do everything to make sure that this event will be the best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. I'm sure you've seen many things around, but you've not seen the longitude of Arajuku. The longitude of Arajuku, the cradle of slave trade. You've not also seen the Blue River in Okwa. These are things you need to see. Very inviting. Even if you don't know how to swim, when you behold the Blue River in Okwa, you'll marvel. You know, there are so many things that within our space here in Abia that you can. Those of you who are very, very creative, I understand what it takes to, you know, be in level and status. You see great things you can do with the things that God has given to us naturally. We are wonderful people with a lot of energy, very enterprising, and as you plan for the Bon Awards in Abia, I wish and pray that God will bless our endeavor and bless our hands, so that at the end of the day we'll have something to be very, very, very proud of. And once again, you can take my support and the support of our government for granted. And, let us say that this is the beginning of very, very wonderful and great things to come. I believe that by the end of this award, people will come to see Abia from an entirely thank you very much for coming. I thank you for the time you spent even in my absence, and say to you that it's my desire to make sure that I find time in future to spend a little more time with you than I have done this time. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you, Excellency. So,
the words of Dr. Ikpeazu shows that he has Nollywood at heart. His intent for the film industry brightened the countenance of the actors seated.